I'm Jennifer Whitestone. I'm a biomedical engineer at Total Contact. I love my job. It's a tremendous opportunity to bring the field of engineering into medicine and to help, for instance, burn survivors regain full function and use of their face through the use of burn masks, help construction workers remain safe with a fall protection harness that actually captures them and holds them safely. Rollover protection is used to protect the farmers. We've been working in that field. And protecting firefighters, making their gear fit so that we are preventing injuries and fatalities. It's a very exciting field, and I feel very blessed to have the opportunity to use engineering and to bring it into the field of medicine and to help others and really improve upon the quality of life. We deal primarily in the field of surface scanning technology, so our solutions are essentially using surface scanning and applying it to the problem. Surface scanning is capturing the surface in three dimensions, so you're getting the contours and shape. It's used, for instance, widely in the movie making industry for animation and graphics, in the gaming industry. We use it for applying to interface issues with equipment items that in some way interface with the human body. One of our primary products is to create a total contact burn mask. And essentially, we're taking a three-dimensional scan of the patient's face, so we're capturing their contours, the shape of their face, and duplicating that in a mold, creating a mask that fits them exactly. So it's a perfect fit. It puts pressure on the scars that tend to result from severe burns, and it keeps the scars from building up. So essentially, if a burn patient wears the mask for up to a year, then it minimizes the scars and brings back the function and form to their face. We're currently working with the firefighting industry to improve upon their equipment fit, particularly the fit of firefighters in the fire engine seat. It turns out that fire engine seats were designed for young military men who were essentially measured in shorts from about 40 years ago. As a matter of fact, firefighters are 20 to 25 pounds heavier than the general non-military population, plus they're wearing their civilian clothes and their turnout protective gear on top of that. Adding all of this bulk makes it very difficult for them to fit in the fire engine seat, and so as a result, many firefighters are being ejected from fire engines on the way to the scene of an accident. So we were tasked to measure firefighters and to improve upon the design of the fire engine seat and the restraint system to help protect the firefighter. The firefighting industry has actually changed quite a bit. There are more and more women that are going into firefighting, many more minorities, and as a result, we're finding that the firefighters are not fitting into their equipment items safely. So for instance, the boots aren't fitting women, and I've talked to female firefighters who said, I have literally stepped out of my boot during a fire, or my gloves aren't fitting to the extent that I have the dexterity to do my job. So we are working with the firefighting industry to measure the human body so that we can make this protective equipment fit better and therefore allow them to do their job properly and safely. Another example is the ladder. The rungs on a ladder are set at 14 inches apart. And no one has really evaluated if a firefighter is stepping on the rungs of that ladder and they have their turnout gear and their boots and they're possibly carrying someone, is that really the optimal distance between the rungs, or should it be 12 inches or 10 inches? So we're working toward the ergonomic issues and improving upon that for firefighters to make their job safer. We're also working with the construction industry to help protect construction workers. When they're working on scaffolding and high rises, they wear what's called a fall protection harness. And it's a full body harness that is meant to capture them. It's anchored to the building or the structure. In the event that they were to fall, the fall harness would capture them and hold them safely. The fall harnesses, however, were originally made for men. Again, more females are coming into the construction industry, and it's not fitting their hips and legs in the same way, and it's not effectively keeping them safe. So we scanned using a whole body three-dimensional surface scanning system. We captured the surface scan of the construction worker with their fall protection harness, and we're able to look at how the harness deforms under the weight of the individual, geometrically how it fits on that person, and working with the manufacturers to help improve upon the fit. Another project we've worked on is protecting farmers during a rollover. Tractors are very prone to rolling over because the center of gravity is very high, and if they hit a pothole, they tend to roll over. So it's important to protect the farmer if this event occurs. And so we again scanned farmers in a John Deere tractor seat and looked at the volume around which we would need to protect the farmer during a rollover scenario, and worked with John Deere to improve upon the rollover structure. Well, you certainly have to prepare yourself to go into engineering by selecting the classes carefully in high school. So calculus and biology and chemistry are very important in high school to prepare you for going to college. But also, if at all possible, technical writing or any kind of writing classes are important, because any time that you work on a project, that you work on an application, you have to be able to communicate your results. You have to be able to present them and to write them up clearly. I decided to go into engineering at a very young age because as a child I had surgery that required a brace for my back. And I was told by the doctor that a team of biomedical engineers designed the brace, and without the brace, I would have been bedridden for at least a year. And I thought, wow, biomedical engineering has impacted my life to the extent that they gave me a year. So I thought that was a pretty exciting field, and I've never looked back. I really enjoyed biomedical engineering.
Less available, we wouldn't even be able to be operating the buildings to begin with. So the future of green design is the future of design.